Hey guys, it's Melvin7 here. Today I'm bringing you episode 17 of Transfer Rumours. I've got a blocked nose, so my commentary is going to be worse than normal. But anyway, let's kick this off with Gonzalo Higuain, the third biggest transfer ever. And it has been fully confirmed. I did basically say it was all but done in the last episode, but now it's all officially announced. He's the number 9 for Juventus. And yeah, as I said in the last one, regardless of the fee, this is a player that Juventus need. They lost Morata, so now they're getting the best Serie A goalscorer in the last 4 years. They're taking him off one of their nearest competitors for the title, and now they're bringing them onto their already ridiculous team. They're all but certain to win Serie A again next season, and now they want to push for the Champions League. Whether that happens, we'll have to wait and see, because obviously there's a lot of other strong competitors for the Champions League, so no matter who you buy, it's always going to be a challenge to win it. But they're certainly more... well, they're a better team with Higuain there. So, yeah, I believe, irrespective of the fee, this is a great buy for them. Next player we've got is Lacazette. Arsenal had a confirmed £29 million Euro bid rejected by Lyon. And whether they're going to go back into it, we'll see. But I put a tweet out and a few Arsenal fans seem to agree with me. But I think this is a case of Arsene Wenger looking at West Ham, who bid £31 million last month for Lacazette, and that got turned down. He's now bidding £29 million and thinking, oh, well, I know it's going to get rejected, but at least I'm trying. I'm trying to get a striker. I'll bid less than what West Ham did because I know I'll get rebuffed in my efforts. They're not going to accept it, so we won't actually be paying that. But at least I tried to get a striker. And, yeah, that just seems what this is about, because he would have knew the West Ham deal. Well, the West Ham bidded more, so why bid less a month later? The same club aren't going to reject it. Aren't going to accept it this time for less money. So unless they come in for an improved offer, I think that's what he's doing at the minute. Obviously, their chief executive, Gazidis, has said they're not going to spend. There's ongoing rumours with Mahrez. Will he, won't he move? But we'll have to wait and see with Arsenal. It must be very frustrating as a fan because they're so close. Their squad is so close, and they seem to never get the key components year upon year that they need. And now with Mertesacker out for 5 months, they also need a centre-back. There's reports of Mustafi, who would be a fantastic buy. Valencia have apparently put him on the market for €25 million. That's got to be bullshit, because there'll be a whole host of clubs, not just Arsenal, that will activate that. I want Manchester United to activate that. For that type of player, to get him for that cheap, that's unbelievable. And yeah, if Arsenal did get him, then that would make them a whole lot stronger. They're also linked to Fabian Shaw of Schalke, I think. But whether any of these deals happen, we'll have to wait and see. But Wenger did say he wants a more experienced centre-back, because now Per Mertesacker is out for 5 months. So they're forced into it. It's not because they wouldn't have had this injury not happened. And that's what Arsene Wenger's saying. So maybe this injury in the long run will benefit Arsenal. Anyway, next up on the rumour front, we have got Koulibaly. Chelsea have got an official £38 million bid. It's all done. They've sent it in, but Napoli have yet to respond. Now, the player wants to move. His agent said he does want to move, and this was the fee that supposedly Napoli would have had to accept. But Napoli are playing hardball. They've just lost Higuain. They've got a fuck ton of money. They don't need any more money. But the thing that makes this deal likely is the player and his agent want to force the move. And when you've got an unhappy player, it's very hard to keep them, regardless of what your stance on the transfer is as the club. So I do expect this one to happen, but they're certainly stalling. They're not responding to the bid, but they're going to have to eventually. So we'll see what happens with this. But £38 million would make him the second most expensive defender in the world. It shows how inflated transfer fees are now. Like £30 million we paid for Eric Bailly, £38 million for Koulibaly, a player who's had a very good season in Serie A. Same as Eric Bailly for Villarreal. He had a fantastic season as well. But this is what happens. Otamendi had a fantastic season when he moved to Manchester City and got a huge fee. This is what happens. You have one exceptional year, especially as a centre-back, and you know you can sell them for a hell of a lot of money. Now, I know Mangala in total cost £42 million, but that's £10 million agent fees. So officially, he was £32 million, making Koulibaly, if this went through, the second most behind David Luiz, who of course went from Chelsea to PSG for £50 million. But anyway, aside from that, I do think this one will happen. It's just a matter of time. Next up, we've got another centre-back that would be the joint most expensive centre back, maybe the most expensive due to well, whatever the final fee is, but it's roughly supposedly around 50 million, and that is for John Stones to Manchester City. Now, a very, well, I was going to say a very good player. As of yet, he's a good player with a lot of potential, but it's whether you can unlock that potential. He's obviously got quality, but he needs to display it a bit more. He is very, very young, and there's a lot of hype around him, but I think if he wasn't English, there is no way he'd be anywhere near 50 million. Like, I'm talking about good seasons for Koulibaly, for Eric Bailly, but Stones hasn't really had that type of season where he's been absolutely phenomenal for the full year. So the fact that he's 50 million, it's unbelievable. But of course, transfer fees are forgotten, and I'm a strong believer it doesn't matter what you pay, as long as the player you get is someone you need. Manchester City do need a centre back, and yeah, whether they perform, if they perform, it really doesn't matter what the transfer fee is, and it's up to the club what they pay. So Manchester City have an abundance of money, so 50 million, it's pennies to them. So if it goes through, then I think he will certainly unlock some of that potential. Whether he'll be world class, we'll have to wait and see. But yeah, 50 million, maybe slightly more than what David Luiz went for, because it might be like 51.4 million. We'll see what the final figure is, but it is strongly believed that Manchester City will officially bid this in the next few days, so we'll have to wait and see on that one. And the last rumour I've got here is Robin van Persie, all but set to join Rangers, of all people. The Scottish League, which I'm sure he'd excel in that league. He'd get top scorer, he'd be phenomenal in that league. And he's as short odds as 1 to 5, which means if you put £10 on, you're going to get £12 back if you bet on this. So it's very short odds, because a flurry of bets have came in. And I'm not sure where the rumours actually originated from, but it looks highly likely judging by the betting markets. They don't go that short for no apparent reason, especially in a very short space of time. So RVP to Rangers looks set to be nailed on. So what are your thoughts on any of these rumours? Are there any I've missed? Let me know in the comment section. Hopefully you have enjoyed. Subscribe if you haven't already. Like the video. And yeah, peace.